So on top of my design aesthetic, which is pretty unique in itself, I built my collection using laser technology. And I mean laser engraving, laser cutting. You can see here in the little video a bracelet being laser cut and laser engraved. And in a sense, the engraving is a kind of an homage to those anonymous artists who carved stones and built those monuments that we've seen before in the pictures. Laser technology allows me to offer customization and made-to-measure services for my customers. It allowed me as a designer to develop prototypes, experiment easily, quickly, and economically. Another feature of my product is the sustainability of the materials. I use a Tuscan vegetable tanned leather, which was tanned without chrome, and which is environmentally friendly. So I did a lot of research, very passionate about research, and I was able to draw a line from those ancient ideas of beauty and design. That line kind of connects with the modern times, with the modern customers. And I was able to select, refine, and develop a collection of patterns. This is a selection of patterns. Each of them attracts a different type of customer. These patterns are incorporated into products. They define the product themselves. So it's a part of the branding. So for example, a product is the leather jewelry. And I mean leather, for example, leather bracelets. They're all laser engraved, laser cut, and then hand finished. They're made with premium Tuscan vegetable tanned leather. They're available in 7 colors, in 5 sizes, and with an entry price range between $90 and $160. Here are some images of the bracelets. This is the color range in the Casta bracelets. Clean details and minimalist. Slightly more shape into the oval shape, the kind of a Berber inspiration. More Moorish, intricate geometric tessellation. My mission as a brand carries both a cultural and a social responsibility. My cultural responsibility is to promote Moroccan heritage and aesthetic, to revive Moroccan traditional arts and crafts by collaborating with different artisans throughout Morocco, in Fez, Marrakech, Rabat, Meknès, and other cities, through a commitment to excellent quality and refinement. On the social level, my goal is to offer job opportunities for Moroccan youth in terms of leather manufacturing by producing in-house in Morocco and by collaborating with different governmental agencies to develop training programs in leather manufacturing. In terms of competitors, I compete with 3 categories of brands. Luxury brands that are known for their leather goods. And I compete also with small jewelry brands offering leather accessories and leather jewelry. I compete with traditional, classic, non-fashion-oriented leather good brands. In terms of addressable market, I'm targeting a 4% of the luxury leather good market, which is worth $49 billion. It is part of the global leather market. Global leather good market, which is worth $217 billion in 2016 and is expected to grow to $271 by 2021. You've seen I have different products, and each of them is targeting kind of a diversified niche. My customers' age is between 18 and 65. They're both men and female. I consider my designs to be pretty unisex. Their lifestyle, they enjoy outdoor activities, traveling, cultural activities, exploring new things. They live on East Coast, West Coast, and other coastal cities. Why do they like and why do they enjoy my products? First, because of the creativity, the unique and exclusive style. It's pretty innovative. The other quality is the sensorial quality of the leather. They enjoy the feeling of a second skin, the color, power, the patterns. And everything, all these features are attractive for these clients. In terms of social media strategy, my goal is to interact and develop a relationship with customers. I plan to gain more followers and customers by offering a strong value proposition. to engage with them through a visual communication, creativity, immediacy, immediacy and intimacy, to promote the products by a selection of influencers, bloggers, and micro-celebrities, to schedule and share across multiple media and social platforms, to kind of connect, contact, and interact directly and publicly with these customers, and to, throughout this social media strategy that I pursue, I will analyze constantly and continuously in order to assess the data and to retain a customer base. In terms of my first year financials, I'm aiming to raise $25,000, which will cover both my materials, supplies and tools, machinery, facilities and rent, and labor, having in mind that I would like to produce in-house in Morocco. Why Morocco? Because I think the future of production is in Africa. The leather industry is a strategic sector for many African countries, and Morocco as an African country offers a great manufacturing and employment opportunities, and also because it's part of my vision, the social responsibility and the human development of the brand. Here's a link for my website, and I brought a few samples. These are products that I designed and I made myself, so I've been in the whole process of the development. Thank you, everyone.
Can we see some of the products?
Of course. In terms of management team, I would like to collaborate with people in the social media and the PR, because that's I'm not an expert, and also in the more financial, pure financial side of the business. In terms of design and manufacturing and production, that's more my field. And that's why I'm in the entrepreneurship program, so I'm learning and I'm embracing the entrepreneurial skills throughout this program. So I'm learning a lot about the business and how to run the business as a designer.
Yeah. So you'll need some top managers, and maybe you'll grow into that. And the marketing side and the creativity side, you said you've got. And then you've got the sales and marketing side, which I see you're going to outsource. Mm-hmm. Just don't forget the top management part. Great.
Thank you. Well, I'm a marketing guy first and foremost. How's the consumer going to get this product? Is it strictly online, or are you going to build a retail network?
It's going to be online in a few boutiques and specialty stores. Mm-hmm. So starting with bit by little, and also trying to reach out to customers also through social media. Because from my experience selling the products, I've been selling them in the past year, and I've gained probably 50% of my customers came from Instagram and social media.
But when they come respond to your social media campaign, will they then send you an order, a request for you, or will you direct them to retailers?
It depends. Sometimes they would purchase directly through the website, or they would be, I would address them to a retailer, a few retailers that happen.
I think the best thing is your storytelling. Mm-hmm. You told a great story, and I think that's how you capture the consumer. So that was really great. Your products are beautiful. I think it's just about setting up the team for all of this. I think that's what you need. You need more people to help you because you can't do everything. I think we tend to want to do everything. I'm that kind of person. I want to be the designer, the financial person. I want to do everything. But you have to give some of that up and build a team for yourself because you have a great product.
Thank you for presenting. Your stuff is totally beautiful. I think with the storytelling, I think there's still some opportunity for you. I think one of the things that I see, like, I'm first, like, you are a doctor who's in design, and you are a Moroccan who now lives in New York, and the specific architecture and buildings that you reference are buildings that went through major transformations, right? Like, they're buildings that literally took on different religious representations throughout time. Yeah. But I think that there's a story that you could really push there some more. Like, I think the rationale for why the Moorish designs versus, you know, like, why you're picking each design and why those were the six designs that you chose to pick could be not just pushed more, but it's a beautiful, there's a lot of weight there. And I think a lot of that weight actually ties back to who you are and why you want to create these products. I think for me, I do have some questions around sort of where, similar questions, like where you're selling them, what your website looks like, how much your shipping is, who your audience is. And I think, like, one of the things that I heard that I would push you to explore some more is you said your niche audience is, I think, people from 18 to 65. It's a really large range. Sure, there's an 18-year-old and a 65-year-old who would both love to have, you know, any of these leather products, but I think that honing in some more on who exactly it is that is the ideal customer, I would suggest, you know, like, doing some persona and typing. It could be that you have three or four, but what is the 65-year-old look like that wants your product, and what does the 18-year-old look like that wants your product? They're different. And I think the other thing that I'd like to see is when you had your competitors, there's definitely a range, and I'd like to see where you see your products in that range.
For the competitors, it was I focused the competitors for the leather jewelry.
Okay.
So that was a focused competitors. In terms of the customers, I said 18 to 65 because in the different categories, each category is appealing to a different age category. I can go with every product appeals to a perfect customer. Mm-hmm. And that's why I've kind of diversified in terms of products in order to target different customers and different kind of niches. Mm-hmm. Different people like that enjoy different things. But the common thing that cements the whole is the aesthetic.
Okay.
So kind of that's kind of implemented and incorporated in all the products.
I think as you explore your branding and your marketing and your team some more, you'll find that how you're doing those things, the strategies for those will change depending on who your persona is. So if all six or seven of your products have a different audience, it for launch might make it difficult for you to create a strategy around the actual buying power of those audiences. So I would, you know, it might be that they're totally independent, they do have different audiences, but I think that you might be able to tell a story that allows you to find, you know, the perfect one.
Follow-up question. You stated some projected prices. Do you know what your cost might be? Like, if you have a $90 item, what is your target cost?
For production here or in Morocco? In Morocco, it would be way cheaper than more economical than if I produce, for example, in the United States. One in Morocco and one maintaining the very high quality, I would be able to produce in an economical way. Mm-hmm. And through, this is just the entry prices. Throughout the business, I would like to develop more custom hardware. The more hardware, the more custom things you add to your product, the more the prices go up. For example, for the leather bracelets, these are just leather. So that's for $90, $160 for just leather. It's pretty high. It's a higher price point than other bracelets that you can see on the market. And you have definitely the option of customizing. Meaning with the laser cutting, you don't have to engage into like a die cutter in which you have to spend a lot of money into developing one die cutter. Laser cutting allows you to kind of do many, many things.
So just to add what I said, I think what you've got is great. But to add something about cost of production in Morocco, and here's the gross profit, mm-hmm. I have cost of production here, which might be estimated for the first 6 months until we wrap up in Morocco, whatever your time frame is. I think, as you said, segmenting the market shows a lot of depth of perception. You give some beginning stuff, but the people in Albany might want to see that you've got the depth of perception to know that you have different market segments. And you're going to have a rollout strategy for one market versus the next market versus the next market in terms of quarterly or half month or full year rollout.